I am a Zambian citizen. I'm writing this letter to be delivered to the president. Mr. President, I appreciate your kindness and your love for Zambia. But to tell you the truth, the future is still not safe. The future has been sacrificed. The well-being of my youths has been crucified. We can't speak. Our voice is caged. We fear the cops. The freedom of expression attracts detention. Education has become rigid. The poor cannot be certified. Corruption is still pandemic. Development is still static. Statistics show that more than 50% youths are jobless. Poverty has crossed its elastic limit. It's now plastic. Mr. President, you are no longer a politician. Instead, you are a leader. I don't see the reason why you should campaign for a certain candidate in a by-election. Worst of it all, you promise the people development if they vote your candidate. That means you don't consider the voice of the opposition, and that leaves the opposition hopeless. It influences anger, and that anger causes violence. I'm not here to challenge you, but I'm simply here to ask you one question. Mr. President, how long will it take for you to accomplish your promises? I mean, did you know that some people still drink water from shallow wells? Mr. President, did you know that some people from rural areas walk miles just to reach schools? Did you know that youths have remained jobless because getting a job needs a tactic? Mr. President, how does that make you feel? Where are the jobs you promised to create? The more money you promised our pockets? You promised to attend to our needs, but now you only visit us because of by-elections in our sections. This neglection and rejection brings anger, and anger brings violence. We've had enough of this madness already. I'm afraid of the cops too, but truth must be told. I don't need to be a member of parliament to say our good people need good roads. When millions are spent on upgrading township roads and subways but neglecting to do roads that are of economic value to the country. Visit Chama that supplies rice. The road is a total mess. Targets have become useless because millions are missing, and we still have the guts to spend more millions on few people's comfort to make a friendly visit abroad, and the survival of a million people is ignored. Mr. President, I may have crossed my bounds, but you have to hear me out. Untreated poverty will cost us more than the idle ministries in our country. If we decide to put politics and our ego for more money ahead, ignoring the cries of our people, especially the youths, the cost will be 10 times to cover the sorrow that will befall us tomorrow, when we will have thousands of uneducated young men and women because they could not access schools when they were young boys and girls, when we will have to treat diseases every day because we refuse to give people clean water to drink, when the people will have nothing to eat but handouts every day from government, when crime levels will be high because our young men and women will decide to do something about their situation, when our girls will lose their dreams because they will have to get into early marriages for economic reasons, when HIV infections will rise because some of our girl children will have nothing to sell but their bodies, when the number of street kids will rise because their parents will be killed or disabled because of the political violence, and finally, when the poverty gets that high, the poor will have nothing to eat. They will eat those that ate something. And at that time, the future must have closed. The 2030 vision must have become a failed mission. Everyone will point a finger at the other. Confusion will consume us all. Can't we believe again? Can't we abandon the influence of violence and focus on making living better? Can't we put politics aside and use the term wisely? I do not accept the polluted future. I still have a dream. I have a dream that one day Zambia will rise above its challenges. It shall rise like our noble ego in its flight. We shall reclaim our dignity, our complete freedom and sanity. Politicians will act as leaders without politic minds, and our hearts will say, Ebenezer. This is how far the Lord has brought us. And on that day, every Zambian will see what they can achieve if they vote for leaders and love one another. Yours faithfully. Dear Zambian, this coming election, be it a ward, constituency, every other election, do not vote because of some catchy song by your favorite artist, Popeza Izo, Zitibweza Kumbuyo. Let us not open doors for politicians to destroy our future. Let us not give our vote to any politician. Instead, let's vote for leaders. Let's vote the future and save the future.